In 1979, Fangoria magazine sliced its way onto the scene, becoming the only national magazine devoted to the horror, thriller, and suspense genre.
Hello, welcome to Fangoria. Come on in.
I'm Michael Gingold. I'm the managing editor of the magazine and one of the editors and contributors to the Fangoria website. Horror genres is one of the oldest genres in film history. There were horror films pretty much from the beginning of cinema. And it's always been a place for people to experiment with different forms. You know, back at the early days of silent horror like Nosferatu and the Cabinet of Dr. Caligari, filmmakers were using the genre as a vehicle to really be creative with photography and lighting in ways that more traditional genres like dramas and such wouldn't really support. And to this day, horror is a place where you find a lot of the most interesting filmmaking going on. You have a lot of people who start out in the genre and then move on to other things. Sam Raimi is a perfect example, or Peter Jackson. It's a great genre for people to start off with in terms of being commercial.
I'm Tony Timpone of Fangoria Entertainment. I've been an editor with the magazine since 1985. For a couple of years, Fangoria was a host of the Village Halloween Parade. We even filmed it for TV. We've hosted free screenings of several horror movies in New York and Chicago, Los Angeles. It's always been about the fans, making the fans happy, giving them a magazine every month that, you know, they could call their own, and having a screening where they could come and see a horror movie in advance, or having a radio show where they could listen to their favorite horror celebrities talk about their new films. So it's always, to see the joy that the magazine brings to people has always been very gratifying for me, not more than anything else. You know, horror is a release. It's cathartic. You have a bad day in the office, you have a bad day at home or whatever, you go to a horror movie and you scream, you laugh, and you get it all out. You know, it's a release of all these pent-up emotions. And you know, Fangoria has really been a great friend to the independent horror filmmaker, because they see that they get the exposure they need for their films to be discovered and found by, you know, casual moviegoers. And in Fangoria magazine and on Fangoria.com, we celebrate, you know, just this whole wide array, this huge universe of horror entertainment that's out there and that's available to people right at their fingertips. There's just so much great stuff in the horror genre just waiting to be discovered. It's not just remakes or PG-13 horror movies or, you know, stuff you get on the web. There's just so much content out there. And Fangoria is really great at filtering really the best out of the bunch, the best and bloodiest that horror has to offer.
I'm Bill Hall, and I do a lot of the video for Fangoria. And what I mean by I do the video is I shoot, I edit, I do pretty much all of the motion graphics that Fangoria TV has. I worked with Tom DeFeo, who is the owner of Fangoria. I've worked with him for almost 20 years. It was difficult for me to get an interview with Clive Barker or with whoever. All of a sudden, I was calling on behalf of Fangoria, and boom, everybody wants to talk to us. There are so many people out there who I've talked to outside of Fangoria who actually read Fangoria growing up. And it's really cool to be part of that. I interviewed these couple of guys from the Dillinger Escape. The reason they wanted to be talked to by us is because it's Fangoria. It's like, I've been reading Fangoria since I was a little kid, and now I this is so cool. I'm being interviewed by Fangoria. The fact that I can pick up the phone and get a hold of whoever, Robert England or whatever, because I'm Bill from Fangoria. Fangoria has this name. It tells you a little bit about the magazine. It tells you a little bit about the name and the brand, Fangoria.
I'm Marla Newborn. I'm a writer here at Fangoria. I'm also a production manager and an office manager and really everything else at Fangoria, since we all wear many hats, and work on Fangoria magazine, Fangoria online at Fangoria.com, and our offices are here in New York City, and we travel around the country as we are national and internationally known. Everybody loves Fangoria, and I love being here. Over the years, we've done some incredible work here at Fangoria, and it's been a tremendous amount of fun, but of course a tremendous amount of work, as we've we've been trying to build this company up and branch it out into, you know, many different directions. And it's still very much a work in progress because, you know, Fangoria is a magazine, and in the age of the internet, you know, print is, they say print is dead. You know, we don't believe that. People will always want to read a magazine. But we are expanding. We have a very, very dynamic website, and we are embarking on doing some thing called a video on demand. I champion the short filmmakers because short films in this country and really all over the world, they don't really get a lot of recognition. You don't go to the movies these days and see short films running prior to a feature that, let's say, in the 1940s you used to see. And so people make short films now, and they don't get a lot of accolades. Maybe they play in a few festivals, they get a lot of applause, but there's no money in that. And people who are making the short films, the directors, the writers, they put their heart and their soul and their blood and the sweat and the tears into it, and then it's done. Films are made every year that never get seen. Like scripts are written that never get read. And, you know, Fangoria is about championing those kind of people. What I would like to do is make an online film festival for short filmmakers. There are tons and tons of film festivals all over every country. Every city in the country has a film festival. I would like to create that on Fangoria.com. You know, anything that can kind of promote people to want to be creative. Over the years, this company has printed over 1,000 magazines.
This is our stock room. This is where we keep all our back issues. And we sell them online. We sell them at conventions. And we keep them for ourselves. Sometimes our employees actually come get a sneak peek if they need it for a lunch break or, you know, just for a little bit of pleasure, you know. This is where it all happens, right here, everywhere. You gotta be pretty tall to get up there. Not your typical corporate office. We're really happy. See, we have a good time here. These guys are wordsmiths. They make the magazine sing. As a result, we produce a kick-ass magazine. Hey now.